Right, YouTube. In this video, we are going to see how to create call tracker app with the help of JavaScript. This is a paid JavaScript tutorial. You can see I'm just inserting my current goals, and if you wish, I have completed the AngularJS, so I'm ticking it, and you can filter it. If you click on completed, your completed task shows up. If you click uncompleted, the thing which is not completed shows up. If you click on all the things are getting visible. Now if you see, even after page refresh, it is not going up because I have stored this value inside the local storage along with the state of the list. You can see the checked is already there even after the page refreshed. You can also delete the item from the local storage. If you see, if you wish to delete Node.js, it is getting deleted from the local storage even after page refresh. The local the Node.js is not showing up because it's in the local storage. It's fetching the data from the local storage. Fine. Now let me add some task which I would be doing in this current month. If you see, I have completed React.js, Node.js, and on the uncompleted section, the two which I have completed shows up. If you wish to delete, you can delete it. And this is my 23rd JavaScript project. To get to follow with me, I'll leave the source code in the description. Fine, these are the steps which we are going to do right now. So create dynamic list. Now we are going to create dynamic list. Fine. Now this is a zip. You'll get index file, script file, and one style sheet. Let me start the script from scratch. Let me store it in the backup.txt so that in case if we stuck, we can see it. Now the script file is blank. Now let me explain the HTML for you. First of all, we have a heading and we have a form section. This is the heading and this is totally the form section, and this is the UL which will be dynamically populated. Fine. Inside the form we have action, note that action, and then we have a input, we have select, and we have a submit button, and note that each of the element has an ID. Now we are going to get all the elements in the JavaScript. To get the element by the ID, this is a query, pass the ID over here and store the ID in the variable. Likewise, we have form element, input element, the select tag, and the unordered list. Fine. We have four elements. Let me copy paste four times and paste this element. Form is in the variable form, input tag is in the variable input, and select tag is in the variable select, UL tag is in the variable UL. Fine. Next, we are going to add listener to the form. Choose the form and add listener submit. That means when I click on submit button, I want a function to get executed. So the function will be as a second parameter, will be the second parameter, and what I need is I want to show you a message like you clicked button. Now you can see, now we are going to get the input value. So this is the input value, dot value. With the help of dot value, we can get the text of the input on button click. I have, if you see, let me refresh it. Type something on the input field and click on the button. You can see hello shows up. Now create an object with two property. In JavaScript, you would be creating property with the name. Let me store it before that. Let me store it, the input text, into a variable called input text. Now we have a variable and this variable holds the object. So this is how we define object, key value pair. Let the key, you can give any key. In my case, I am giving gold txt, and the value for it will be the input text. And the second property is done, and the value is false. Now pass the object to array, pass the goal. Let me create an, let me initialize an object first. Now pass the object goal to the array goals. with the help of function push. Fine, now create a function to dynamically fill the unordered list. We want to create a list item on the unordered list. For that, I'm creating a function called populate, and we are going to use a map function to access the object values, or you can say to access the array values. Sorry for that. Now we can access the object one by one with the along with index number. So it will, this map will return an HTML element which is li. Let me take more space so that I can clearly show you what we are up to. We need one list item, and this list item will have one text, two buttons. The first button will be the check mark, and the second button will simply be the delete. We have created two buttons. Now this is a font awesome icon. Let me add font awesome icon. Fine, let me properly show you. Now inside li we have one text node and two buttons. That's what I'm showing you. Now in place of text, I need the value of object, which is gold.txt. Fine, now let's create a class, bootstrap class, button success, so that we can get some padding and background color for this button. Along with that, I'm passing a class name so that we can access it in the and perform some operation. Now change the color to danger, which is red, and let me give the class deleted. Now along with that, I'm going to pass the ID. The ID would be the index number. I'm going little fast at this tutorial because I have already completed this in the previous tutorial, which is 22nd. Now this is the 23rd. Now convert the returned array to string. To convert into string, this is an array. We will the map will return an array. To convert it to string, use the join function. Now append the list. This is a list item. To append it, call the ul, and with the help of inner HTML, append it. Now pass the index number. We have already done it. We have passed the ID. Sorry, we have created the ID and passed the index number. Now it's for the validation. If the input text is not blank, then perform these operations, or else show the message, which is an alert message, which will say enter at least one goal. And fine, if you click on set goals, it's blank right now. Let me clear the local storage first. Fine, it says enter at least one goal. Fine, now if I enter something, and it will populate on the unordered list. Now it's working. You can see even after I set the, you can see the classes are added. Now this step is completed. Now let's get into the other step, which is add functionality to check button. So when I click on add button, when I click on a check button, a class should get appended. So for that, we're going to use the event delegation, choose a parent and add a listener to it, which is click, and this, and let me show you. You clicked on the ul, but we want to add listener only to the checkbox, sorry, check button. Now this listener is adding to the whole ul. You can see even if I click on the uli, it is giving you clicked on ul. Even if I click on button, it shows the alert. Now get to know where it is clicked. To get to know, we can use e.target, which will give you where we have clicked it. Let me open the console tab. Let me type and enter the goal. If you click on li, we can see there is an error. We haven't passed the event to the function. Fine, let me enter a goal. If I click on li, we console log. Instead of alert, let me console and log it. Now refresh it. Let me add one more time, sorry for that. If I click on li, it says li. If I click on button, it says button. If I click on another button, it says another button with class checked. Now perform operation only the button with checked class. We are going to get this class if our current element is with class check it, then only perform the operation. The operation would be, we would be simply passing the class. If the target has class, which is class list, since we have to pass the index number, the first one is button, the second one is button success, and the third one is check it. Start from zero, so the second index. If it is check it, then I am showing you a message. And that message will simply say, you clicked on checked button. Now let me add a goal. If I click on tick, if I tick somewhere, it is not working. If I click on, it says the message. Now with the help of this, we are going to choose a parent. Here we know the li has two buttons, so the parent would be the list item. This is a button. E.target will give the button, and with the help of parent element, we can choose the list item. Now if I click on it, says we have got the parent. Now since we have got the parent, we are going to add a class to it. The class is simply the checked. Choose the parent, remove the message, which is console log, and add a class, classlist.add, which is this class checked, which will have opacity only. Opacity and a text decoration, which is line through. Line through is barely visible, but opacity is visible. Now let me check. Add a goal, click on set goals. Now if you tick the opacity, the class is added. Now let me check the HTML. You can see the checked is added to the parent. I was clicking on the child, but the class is adding to the parent with the help of parent element in JavaScript. That is working absolutely fine. Now let's get into the another module. Fine. Add functionality to delete button. This would be the same. Now in this case, we will be passing a class name called deleted. And now we are going to add another style, which is remove with style. So this would be adding a transition, which is transform property. Type something and add set goals. Click on the delete button. The class is added to the list item. This is making problem. Let me see what it is. If I click on a submit, I want the text field to get removed. So for that, now it will work. If I type something and click on the button, the text field should be cleared. Yes, that's working. Now I'm going to click on the delete. And you can see the class is getting applied. Along with the class is getting applied, I want the list item to be removed. Let me add the remove function. Let me store it into a variable called, okay, let me remove it. Type something and click on submit. Type another thing. These are the goals. If I remove it, you can see I have added the class, but it's not getting the style. So for that, let me store it into a variable called list item. Now access this list item and add a listener transition end. So what this transition end will do is it will wait till the animation is done. Here in our case, the animation, or you can say the transition, is simply the transform property. It will wait until the transform property completes its task, and then it will remove the list item. Fine, you can see the transition is taking place and then it is getting removed. The list item is getting removed. Fine. Now store, we are going, if you refresh, you can see it is not getting stored on the local storage. Now we are going to get into the local storage section. Save the goal. Here the goal array. Now we are going to use some condition here. If local storage dot get item, we can access the local storage with the help of key. If it is null, then initialize the array. So before that, let me push these value inside the local storage first. To push the value inside the local storage, you have to use set item function and you have to pass a key. This key can be anything. I'm just passing the key itself, and the second parameter will hold the string. Since we are having the array, I want to convert this array to string with the help of json.stringify function. Now you can see it is populated and the value is getting inserted. Type another goal and you can see it is getting updated. Fine. Now what I need is, when I refresh the page, you can see the local storage has the value, but we cannot see on the HTML. So for that we will use this condition: else if the local storage is blank, then initialize the array. If the local storage is not blank, then get all the value. As I have already said, local storage will only have the string. To convert the string to array, I would use json.parse. Now you can see it's visible. Now let's get into the sort. It's time for the sorting. Let me add one goal. Now if you click on check, it's not saving the state and it is not showing up the sorting order. Now let me add a listener to the select tag. Select variable holds the select tag. We have to add listener change, and the function the operation that we are going to do is, we are going to get the value, we are going to display the value. Once we change the select tag, what we need is, we want to display all the list item values with the help of child nodes. Choose the parent, which is UL, and it has all the child nodes. Let me show you. Once I change the select tag, you will get all the list items. You can see we have 9. It's because there are some spaces. Let me remove all the spaces. Here the space is also considered as text node. That's the reason we got 9 text nodes. Let me remove all the blank spaces and make it in a single line. So if you see, if I select something, we are only getting the 4. Now get the value of an option. To get the value of the option, we have already seen e.target will give the current element, and you have to add a property called value to it. to get the option tax value. If you click on completed, we would be getting two what? The first one is node list and the second one is simply the value. Fine. Now get all dynamic create. We have done this. Now we are going to run a for each loop on the node list. The li holds all the node list, which is four node lists at present. We are going to run for each so that we can access one by one, and the one by one will be stored in the variable called one by one object. And now use switch case. We are going to use switch case since we already know the option tag has only three values. So we will pass these three values inside the cases. Case 1, case 2 and case 3. We have three cases. Case all, case completed and case uncompleted. These are the values of the option tag. Now we can access the list item and we want to display block on once I click on all, and I'm going to have a condition. If the list item, we are going to get the class called checked. Let me comment it and show you. Now choose the li and you would get all the li's. Now we are going to check whether the li has a class called class checked. Now we will be getting all the classes. You can see I have added, you can see there are first two list item has the class checked. Now again, first two of them has the class checked. Now by this we can access the class of the list item. So if the list item has the class checked, then display only those list item and the remaining should have display none. Else all of them should have display none. That there is a extra curly bracket, that's the reason why it's behaving like this. This is the thing, remove it, and now that would work. The same way, use it for uncompleted. Get all the list item which does not have the class checked. If I check Angular, on completed it should show completed Angular. And on uncompleted, other than Angular, everything should show up. You can see it's because I have misrearranged. Now it would work. Click I have completed Angular. On completed section, Angular shows up. On uncompleted section, other than Angular, everything shows up. Fine, these things are working. Now let's get into the save the state of checked on local storage. So once I check and refresh, it should save the state. But it's not doing right now. We are going to do it. You can see this object has a second property which is done, which is false by default. We are going to change it. Now once I click on the button check, I want to get the ID of it. So if you see on the HTML, the list item, inside the list item we have button. Two of them as ID 0. We are going to access this ID. Each of them has ID. This ID is simply the index number. Now what we are going to do is we are going to access the array with the help of this index number so that we can get the object. Now we will get the object. If you click on Mongo React, you can see the object related to Mongo, React.js shows up. If you click on MongoDB, the object related to MongoDB shows up. Now we are just going to change the property of it to access the property dot done. Now you can see all of them are false by default. You can see false shows up, false again shows up. Now let me change it to true. Now we are changing the false to true, and this is not enough. We are going to pass the array again to the local storage because we have changed from false to true. I'm going to copy paste it because we need to convert the array to string with the help of stringify function. Now this will not shows up. This will not show up. Now you can see I'm ticking it. It is converting to false, true. It is converting to true. It is converting true. It is again converting to true. But if you refresh, it is not working. It is because this li should have a class called checked. If it is checked by default, all of them would show checked. If it's not checked, now I'm going to use an if else condition. If it is true, then have the class checked, or else leave it nothing. Fine. If you refresh, it's true, that's why it is showing up. Let me delete it and show you again. Clear the local storage. Now let me add an Angular, some task, or you can say some goal. Even if I, after I refresh, the thing is showing up, but the delete section is not working right now because we have not created it. You can see. Now finally we are at the final step, which is delete. The same way, access the ID. And now we are going to use a splice function of array. Call the function, call the array, and use a splice and pass the index number. And we need to remove only one object. For that I'm passing one. So again, convert the array to string and pass into the local storage. Fine. If you remove, you can see it is getting removed. I'm going to remove the MongoDB. Yes, it is removed. I'm going to remove the Angular. It is removed. And that's all for this tutorial. Thank you so much for listening. This is the 23rd project. To follow along, look at all the JavaScript projects in the playlist.